to present the Open Air Interface's contribution to automation in the Magma community, we have Rafael Delacroix, who has been working as a CI/CD expert at OAI since 2018. Along with Rafael, Mohit Bias will present the OAI's contribution from the core network side in the Magma community. Mohit is based in France, and due to time zone considerations, we have pre-recorded his presentation. But Mohit is on the bridge, and if time permits, we will have a Q&A.
Hello, everyone. My name is Mohit Vyas, and I'm working as a software developer at the Open Air Interface. And today, I will be talking about the contribution of the Open Air Interface in the Magma project from the core network's perspective. So let us start from how it all started. The Magma EPC was a fork from the OAI original code, which was known as the OpenAIR CN, and they used the Magma, the OAI code from 2016 as the base. And the last upstream push from Magma to the OpenAIR CN was in the year 2017. Moving forward from here, both the development tracks diverged soon, with Magma worked a lot on the robustification, or say the hardening of the code source based, and the OAI kept on adding new features to cater the needs of the 5G, and also to make sure that we are on the path to make it cloud-native support with full 3GPP compliance in our code. Moving towards the converged MME, this can be best described as the consolidated MME functionality, which caters the needs of both Magma as well as the OAI community. What does this actually mean? This means that over the S6A interface, we can support both gRPC as well as a 3GPP compliant diameter protocol. Over the S11 interface, we can support both embedded S-Gateway and the GTP V2C stack. And for the development environment, we can work with both Debian-based virtual machine and the Docker containers. This project was started in the fall of 2019, and the sole objective of this project is to make sure that both the MME developer communities contribute to the same code base. Let us start from the OAI's contribution to the Magma project. The first contribution which we carried out was the S6A abstraction. The S6A interface is the interface between the MME and the HSS, which is used for the authentication procedure and to obtain the subscriber information related to both location as well as the service. As described in the presentation in the diagram, the S6A interface can support both gRPC activity for the Magma requirement and the free diameter for the full 3GPP compliant based OAI core. Free diameter can be described as an open source implementation of the diameter protocol, which is standardized by the 3GPP and designated to work on the S6A interface. The addition of the S6A task was a primary objective of the S6A abstraction. So when we discuss the interface, S6A interface testing framework, I would like to discuss that we used S1 AP tester, which was Magma native, and the DS tester, which we are using here at the Open Air Alliance. And it works as, let us say, the RAN emulator to test the core. And we used both OAI HSS and the CUFS SP gateway to check with the traffic generator, and we tested with both XS gateway variant from the Magma and the full 3GPP compliant MME variant from the OAI core network. After finishing the S6A abstraction, we worked on the S11 abstraction. S11 interface is the interface between the MME and the S-Gateway and is used to handle events like session creation deletion, default bearer creation deletion, dedicated bearer creation or deletion, and many other LTE events. The S11 interface in Magma supports both embedded SP-Gateway, which is an inter-task thread, which is more Magma native, and the GTP V2C stack, which we used in the OAI core. GTP V2C is a GPRS tunneling protocol and is used to carry the packet radio service in LTE networks. Under the S11 abstraction, our main objectives were to add the S11 task and the GTP V2C stack in the existing Magma code. And the testing framework for S11 abstraction was similar to that of the S6A abstraction, where we used S1AP and DS Tester as RAN emulators, and we tested both the variants, MME and the access gateway, with the traffic server and also with the OAI developed HSS and the CUPS SP gateway. In the final quarter of the previous year, we worked on the 5G non-standalone edition. NSA, or say non-standalone access, is a 5G deployment mode with the control plane of the existing LTE network, while 5G NR focusing mainly on the user plane. The addition of the NSA in Magma started with the upgradation, or say addition of the release 15 based ASN.1C, which was added to cater the needs of the NGAP based services. Moreover, we added some extra messages and new information elements which are based on the 3GPP release 15. Discussing about the testing framework for the NSA, it was a lot different from the S6A and the S11 abstraction, because addition to using the S1AP and the DS tester, for the NSA testing environment, we also used commercial OPPO handsets and some modules from a company called Quectel, and they are based on the latest 5G framework. Please stay tuned at the end of this presentation. We will have a demo of this full NSA connection. This was the story so far, and moving forward, we are planning to optimize the code with some ITTI optimization, and we are planning to add the LTE-M or the NB-IoT support to the existing code as well. In order to summarize the OAI's contribution to the Magma project, this is a small diagram in which we can see that in the first quarter of 2020, we finished the S6A abstraction, followed by the S11 abstraction in the second quarter. Release 15 edition was done in the final quarter of the 2020, and we are in the month of February right now, where we have finished the NSA validation, and moving forward, we are planning to add the NB-IoT support. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Raphaël Devosseux. I am the leader of the DevOps team here at OSA. Today, we'll talk about our contribution of automation to the Magma project, mainly from a continuous integration perspective, also from a continuous development perspective. So, Moritz talked about, during the Converge MME phase, we also developed a pipeline to validate S6A as S11's contributions. And we use the Magma VMs, but also OAI containers. And here you have a view of how the pipeline works. So deep first testing with the Magma deployment with the VM, the so-called no S11, and then rebuild the MME with S11 and testing with the OAI CUPS SP gateway. Since the merge in 2020 July, the pipeline has been officially part of the Magma CI papers, and you have the URL that is maintained by our friends. First, before continuing, I will talk about deployment, so virtual machine versus container. So the Magma usual development flow is using DBR virtual machine to host all the main basic core network services. And the orchestrator is deploying container outside of the VM. OAI prefer a more cloud native approach with plain Ubuntu 18 container for our community, but also we are deploying pods inside the OpenShift cluster here at Euricom. So that means that we have necessity to maintain at least these two OS and to keep our development model working in the Magma master branch. So that's the reason why we are hosting a CI for OAI in Magma. So let's look at it. So it always starts from the Magma repositories, and not only the Magma, but also the OAI GitHub repositories. Then we are linking to a Jenkins server that is also hosted in our OpenShift cluster here at Euricom. And how it does, it's hooked with webhooks. So that means that anytime you have a pull request that triggers a job where we are building an image to test. Once your image is built and validated in terms of that point of view, then we call a child jobs to test not with other components and with stimuli. The approach is the same for our own components like HSS, SP Gateway C, or SP Gateway U. So what does the Magma MME image builder job? So first of all, again, it's triggered by your pull request on the Magma GitHub repository. We do retrieve the source code of your pull request and do a local merge with the current master branch status. That means that we are ensuring that your merge request or pull request is mergeable. Then, for the moment, we are building an Ubuntu 18 MME image that will be tested. And if this build is positive, that means it went to completion, then we call a child job to validate with the rest of the opener CN components and stimuli. So the pipeline URL is this one, and you have the open blue CN view of the stages, so retrieving, building, testing. But the testing, in fact, is a child job. On your pull request, you will have a notification that if it's pass or fails. The child job that is testing versus DS tester is the one that we are also using for all our components. So we are using this third-part tooling, it's called DS tester from developing solution. It emulates the RAN and the UE attachments. So scenarios are developed and used by developer and the CI team. And so that means that they are across the board. Then we are deploying using Docker Compose with parameters that are in line, of course, with the DS tester scenarios. And we pick one of the images to validate, so for example, HSS or the Magma MME. And all the other components are using golden images. So the stimuli and the expected answer checks are done by a framework. So this is totally automated. So you will have a pass or fail criteria for each scenario. So URL is the following one. And again, deploy, test, undeploy. In addition of your GitHub notification, you will retrieve by email a slick HTML report where you will have a summary of the run. So for example, here is the test one. You have the name of your pull request, the name of the branch, the commit that has been tested. You have details on the image that has been used for deployment. So in this case, it was the Magma MME CI temp that is the one for the PR from Magma. And also the details on all the scenarios that has been run. And as you can see, my PR was on Magma, so the test image I used was the Magma MME. So our next steps is also to add another pipeline to build Red Hat 8 images also all the time. Definitely, we need to add more scenarios to the DS tester test suite. So for example, NSA support with the pull request that is currently opened by Mohit, but also later on NB-IoT, X2 handover, and so on and so forth for any future feature that we will adding. For us also at OSA and OAI, what is very important is to have this second child pipeline that will deploy the whole OAI stack. So not only the core network, so with MAMA and the rest of the OpenRCN, but also the RAN. So that means eNodeB and gNodeB attach a 5G commercial phone and do an end-to-end traffic test. For us, it's very important that we do validate the whole stack all the time. Let's talk a little bit of our deployment strategies. So as I mentioned, most of our bare metal Ubuntu community is using Docker Compose. So there is one example in the CI pipeline in the master branch right now. I will do a full tutorial soon, so I don't forget to look at that. But also here at Uricom, we have our own OpenShift cluster. So it's a Red Hat 8 Kubernetes cluster. And we are using Helm Shard to deploy. So you have this GitHub repository where these Helm Shards are located. Get a look and don't hesitate to ask questions. So for example, if I look at the Docker Compose approach, so we are using two Docker private networks. And so we deploy Cassandra with HSS. Then we are deploying a Redis container and with a Magma container. Then I deploy the OAI SP Gateway C and the SP Gateway U, and then the eNodeB and the gNodeB. Everything is containers. Then if you look at the deployment in a cluster, then we have the notion of pods. So pods can contain multiple containers. So here we are deploying three Cassandra pods for robustness. Then we are deploying a pod, for example, this one is HSS with a TCP dump that is a tool for capturing PCAP for debugging purpose. For example, if I look at the MME pod, we are deploying a MME container, so the Magma MME image, the Redis container, and then also again a TCP dump container. And the same way for the SP gateway. So let's look at later on at the demonstration. And thanks a lot for following us. You can always reach us on the Magma Slack workspace. And once again, you are welcome to help us. Bye bye.
Okay, this is Raphael. I'm going to show you the demonstration that we recorded last week. So it is a 5G NSA base with a Magma MME. So I'm deploying the containers using my Docker Compose. It's a bit too small. So don't worry, I will put a link on YouTube for having a better resolution for you guys. So we can look directly at the MME live log file. So we can see that the HSS is connecting through the SXA diameter interface. So I will we will start the OAI in a B by metal on the second server. We can see that he attached in the MME, and we can see the name of the Node B. So it is replaying again for us. So we are using two B210 USRP boards to show that here we have the Node B ready. And we'll start also the Node B, bottom right. So as soon as the Node B started, we have the X2 connection in HTTP with the Node B to do the handling of the NSA support. Again, on the second USRP board, red light on. So we will attach the UE. And we are in 5G. So if we look at on the top right corner, we will see in the SP gateway we see that the IP address of the Node B appear 192.168.18.198. That's the Node B IP address. Thanks a lot. And follow us on social media. We'll have the details of the tutorial.